Washout. A firsthand look as flash floods crashed through a family's camping trip near Wetmore. Powerful storms washing out roads, leading to rockfalls and landslides. Of course, it's a particular concern for those who live near burn scars. We are watching out for you tonight. Hi, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us at 6. I'm Elizabeth Watts.
Good evening. I'm Rob Quirk, and we want that water, but in this case, too much is too much, and it's too fast, especially in those areas below where the Junkins fire burned last year. Multiple areas where the downpour caused those rock and mudslides that you see behind us.
News 5's Bill Folsom was escorted to see the problem firsthand. He is live with tonight's top story. Bill.
Yeah, if you look behind me, the close sign is still up. It is going to be there at least until tomorrow, probably midday. They need to get geo-hazard crews up into the canyon, check the walls for stability. Part of the reason they haven't been up there today, well, you look up this way, we got some really dark clouds. That is a lot less than earlier when it was threatening to rain up there and they had to delay their check. Still, CDOT crews, they have had plenty of damage up there to keep them moving. A rock face along Highway 96 giving way, crashing down and pushing a deep pile of rocks from one side of Highway 96 all the way to the other. It is the result of powerful rain, not just falling, it was pouring down.
Heavy rains in this area.
There are multiple spots along the road where you have to steer clear of boulders, rocks, and debris. Many side roads and driveways are damaged. Exposed culverts and some drainages like this one filled with mud, covering fence posts nearly to the top. The worst is the rock slide closing Highway 96 where it meets Highway 165.
Yeah, we're going to have lots of work between dealing with scaling the rock face here and making sure that's safe and secure to building fences. On 165, the mud washed away about a mile worth of fence, so our crews will be.
Crews have cleared some lanes across from the slide. One directly below remains covered. Crews need an all clear from CDOT specialty geohazard staff before they can work there.
Our geohazard team will come to evaluate the rock face to make sure we aren't going to have additional materials come down, and a lot of that will depend on if we get additional rain.
Stability check is delayed. Dark clouds moving in means staying off the rocks. It makes things slick, and the storm a day ago very possibly left other rocks ready to give way with more rain. The road closure is a hassle, but for now, it is necessary.
It's all about safety.
And we are down about 5, maybe 10 miles below where you're looking at that rock hazard, just outside Wetmore. And as we've been setting up, multiple people have been coming saying you should have seen the amount of water that was coming out. We showed you a little bit, but here's the aftermath. Over just to the left of this tree, you can see where the water reached. And then if you come across from there all the way over, you can see a stream that's just a few feet wide. Well, take that much and take it to the other side. That's how far it went outside of the banks yesterday. A lot of water coming off the mountain. It did some damage. It's going to take a while to clean it up. As far as those safety and evaluations, they're going to be starting first thing in the morning. Watching out for you, Southern Colorado, Bill Folsom, News 5.
Bill,